Hi students, I am Siddhaya. I am working as maths faculty in SRDG PU college. Today I came back with geometry important topic straight lines. If you learn straight lines very well, then you can do better in whole geometry also. So that's why first topic in geometry we are going to start with straight lines. So nice, watch the monitor. If the point 1, 1 is equidistant from the points A plus B comma B minus A and A minus B comma A plus B, then option A plus B equal to 0, option B A plus B equal to 1, option C A equal to B, option D B minus A equal to 1. Watch the board. Students, here this point is equal distance from these two points. P is equidistant from A and B, then we can write it is PA equal to PB. The distance between two points we will denote with PA, PB, like this. If you do the squaring on both sides, PA square equal to PB square. That means here the distance between two points formula is under root x1 minus x2 whole square plus y1 minus y2 whole square. So root is there. When you are doing the square, root will get cancelled. Then if you write the formula x2 minus x1 whole square, that is a plus b minus 1 whole square plus b minus a minus 1 whole square, x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square equal to a minus b minus 1 whole square pb, pb x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square a plus b minus 1 whole square. Now here if you observe, these two terms are similar, so that's why we are eliminating that one. Next one, if you solve these two equations, this square and this square, if you equate this one, so here we can write b minus a minus 1 whole square minus a minus b minus 1 whole square equal to 0. Now this is in the form a square minus b square, then we can write a plus b into a minus b minus a minus of minus plus minus of minus 1 equal to 0. So here the value, it will become minus 2, and here the value will become 2b minus 2a equal to 0. Then by solving this one, we will get b equal to a. So the answer is a equal to b. Here we have to remember, this point is equidistant from these two points, means what is this line will called? See, this is a and this is b, then this is the point. So here this is the point p and this is the point P which is having equidistance, this is the point P which is having equidistance, then the locus of all these points is called perpendicular bisector of AB. So you can find in one more way the perpendicular bisector of AB. Locus means set of points satisfying the same condition. Here the condition given is PA equal to PB. Move to the next question. If the centroid of a triangle is 3 comma 1 and one of the vertices is 0 comma minus 3, then the length of the median is option A 5, option B 15/2, option C 15, option D 10/3. Watch the board. Students, here one vertex is given 0 comma minus 3 and centroid of the triangle given, that is 3 comma 1. Vertex is 0 comma minus 3, centroid is 3 comma 1. Median means if it is ABC, the midpoint of opposite side to A is D, then the line joining vertex to midpoint of the opposite side, it is called median. Now the centroid divides each median in the ratio 2:1. So you can take here the, if you know the distance AZ, then you can find AD equal to 3 by 2 of AG. So the length of the median AD equal to 3 by 2 of AG. So if you observe here AG, if you find the distance under root x1 minus x2 whole square 9, y1 minus y2 whole square 16, root 9 plus 16 is root 25, that is 5. 3 by 2 of AG, 3 by 2 of 5, that equal to 15 by 2. Move to the next question. If C 4 comma K is a point on the line joining A 1 comma 3, B 5 comma 5, then the ratio in which C divides AB, option A 3 is to 1, option B 1 is to 3, option C 2 is to 3, option D 1 is to 2. What's the board? Students, here the point C divides AB. The point C may be at anywhere in this part. So how to find this ratio AC is to CB? This ratio we have to find. Now this is in 2D coordinate system, two dimensional coordinate system. We can take one shortcut formula for this one. What is that? Let the given endpoints are x1, y1, and dividing point is xy, and this is x2, y2. Then we can find this ratio as x1 minus x is to x minus x2. Here y coordinate is k given, so no need to take k. Then we can consider only x coordinate, that is x1 minus x is to x minus x2. If you apply that values, 1 minus 4, that is minus 3, and 4 minus 5, minus 1. So that equal to 3 is to 1. And what you can say, if the ratio is positive, this is internally. He can give the options like internally also. Or if you got the ratio, suppose minus 3 is to 1, you can write in one more way, 3 is to externally. So this is also we can write minus 3 is to 1 or 3 is to 1 externally. So what is the meaning of external internal division? So if it is A, it is B, it is C, it is internal division, and it is A, it is B, and it is C, then C divides AB externally. C divides AB internally, C divides AB externally. That it will come automatically. If ratio is positive, it divides internally. If ratio is negative, it divides externally. Move to the next question. The points A comma B plus C, B comma C plus A, C comma A plus B are option A, vertices of an equilateral triangle, option B, collinear, option C, concyclic, option D, vertices of a right angle triangle. Watch the board. Here three points given, A, B, C. Let them A, B, C. Then if you have any option collinear, so first we have to check the collinearity. How the three points are collinear? How you can say A, B, C, these three points lies on the same line, then we can say these are collinear. So same line means we can take one concept, slope of AB equal to slope of BC. Then we can say these three points are collinear. So if you find the slope of AB formula, y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1. If you observe this one, C plus A minus B plus C, C minus C will get cancelled, A minus B. So A minus B by B minus A. So that equal to, if you take minus 1 common here, A minus B by minus of A minus B, then after cancellation, minus 1. In the same manner, we can do slope of BC, A minus A plus B minus of C plus A, that is B minus C by C minus B, y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1, that also we will get minus 1 only. So slope of AB equal to slope of ABC. So collinear option is there, means it's better to try first collinear. Otherwise, if it is right angle or equilateral, or any isosceles triangle, then we have to find the distance AB, BC, CA. If it is equilateral triangle, these three are equal. If it is isosceles triangle, any two lengths are equal. If it is right angle triangle, we have to find the squares AB square, BC square, CA square. Sum of any two squares equal to third square. It will prove the right angle triangle. So it will be easy only it depending on distance between two points concept. Then different triangles it will exist. If they are collinear, the triangle does not exist. Watch the monitor. The equation of the straight lines passing through the point 3 comma 4 such that the sum of the its intercepts on the axis is 14 is option A 4x plus 3y equal to 24 comma x plus y equal to 2. Option B 4x minus 3y equal to 24 x plus y equal to 7. Option C 4x plus 3y equal to 24 x plus y equal to 7. Option D 4x minus 3y equal to 24 x plus y equal to minus 7. Watch the board. Students, here four options. These are the options given A, B, C, D. Now the question is the line passing through 3 comma 4, passing through the point 3 comma 4 and having intercepts, sum of the intercepts is 14. That is A plus B equal to 14. So if a line, what is the x-intercept A, y-intercept B? If a line is in intercept form, x by A plus y by B equal to 1, then A plus B equal to 14 and this line should be passing through 3 comma 4. So if you observe here verifying the options, that is the best thing. Otherwise you can solve this one also, but solving it will be lengthy. This problem verification is easy. Now see, if you observe option C here, you can write this is x by 4x by 24, x by 6, 3y by 24, y by 8 equal to 1, and this is x by 7 plus y by 7 equal to 1. So these are the intercepts form of the given lines. This is general form, this is intercept form, this is general form, this is intercept form. Now if you observe here, if you substitute the point 3 comma 4 here, 3 by 6 1 by 2 plus 4 by 8 1 by 2 equal to 1, and 3 by 7 plus 4 by 7, that is 7 by 7 equal to 1. That means clearly these two lines passing through the point 3 comma 4 and the sum of the intercepts, x intercept 6, y intercept 8, 6 plus 8 14 and 7 plus 7 14. So these two lines passing through 3 comma 4 and having the sum of intercepts 14. So in competitive exams we can go with verification methods also in straight lines case. So many problems we can do verification methods. This is also one of the problems. Move to the next question. The angle between y equal to x root 3 plus 4 and root 3y equal to x plus 7 is. The angle between y equal to x root 3 plus 4 and root 3y equal to x plus 7 is. Option A 45 degrees, option B 90 degrees, option C 30 degrees, option D 60 degrees. Watch the board. See here, two lines given. So first line and second line. The angle between two lines we have to find. Here options given all acute angles only. So that's why you can apply the formula tan theta equal to mod of m1 minus m2 by 1 plus m1 m2. When we are applying the modulus for the formula, then we will get only acute angle. Tan theta will become positive. If you got suppose theta equal to 45 degrees, then here if it is 45, it is 180 minus theta. It is theta and it is 180 minus theta. So if theta equal to 45, 180 minus 45 is 135. The angle between two lines is always two angles will be there. So that's why first if you can find any acute angle, then you can find the obtuse angle. So I am taking this formula now. Tan theta equal to m1 minus m2. What is the slope of this line? It is in the form y equal to mx plus c. So m is root 3. Here if you convert this one, y equal to 1 by root 3 x plus 7 by root 3. That means here m is 1 by root 3. Y equal to mx plus c. So root 3 minus 1 by root 3 by 1 plus root 3 into 1 by root 3. So if you consider this one, root 3 cancel, 1 plus 1, 2, the denominator, root 3 into root 3, 3 minus 1 by root 3, that you can write 2 root 3, then it is 2 by 2 cancel, 1 by root 3. So when tan theta is 1 by root 3, theta equal to 30 degrees. Sometimes to make you confused, he will give directly root 3 and minus 1 by root 3. If he had given here minus x, then automatically it will become root 3 and minus 1 by root 3 slopes. Then product of the slopes equal to minus 1 means the angle between two lines is 90 degrees. So if two lines are perpendicular, m1 into m2 equal to minus 1 and theta equal to 90 degrees. So this is the formula to find angle between two lines and try to observe in competitive exams immediately. So the lines which are perpendicular. Move to the next question. The ratio in which the line 7x minus 6y plus 1 equal to 0 divides the join of points 1 comma 4 and minus 2 comma minus 5 is option A 16:17 internally, option B 2:5 internally, option C 16:17 externally, option D 2:5 externally. Watch the board. See students, here one line given and two points given. Let it be A and B. This is the line L. So if it is the line L and these are the points like x1, y1 and x2, y2, then he is asking if it is AB line segment, the line L divides in what ratio? AB line segment, that is AP is to PB. So this formula we can write, it is minus of AX1 plus BY1 plus C by AX2 plus BY2 plus C. That we can say simply minus L11 by L22. Like this we can say any line divides the line segment joining two points is minus L11 by L22. So if you solve this one, minus of L11, so that is 7 into 1, 7, minus 6 into 4, minus 24, plus 1. So 7 minus 24 plus 1, that is 8 minus 24, that is minus 16. So minus 16 this value by AX2, 7 into minus 2, minus 14, minus 6 into minus 5, plus 30 and plus 1. So 31 minus 14, that is 17. So that equal to 17. Then it will become 17, that equal to 16 by 17. The meaning of this one is 16:17. So if you observe here, it is positive only. Positive means I said to you, it is internally division. So that's why the answer is 16:17 internally. So for the competitive, this concept also one more important thing. Here in this concept, there is a chance to ask. Here points given and line given. For this point, if it is divides internally, then the points lies opposite sides to the line, opposite sides to each other. And if the line divides the points like this, then the line divides externally, then the points lies same side to the line L, either this side or this side. So what you have to observe, if the ratio is positive, then point, this points lies opposite sides to each other. If ratio is negative, it divides externally means points lies same side to the line. So this is called position of the points to the line, same side or opposite side. Move to the next question. The locus of the point which moves so that sum of the distances from the points a comma 0 and minus a comma 0 is 2c. Option A, x square by c square plus y square by c square equal to 1. Option B, x square by c square plus y square by c square minus a square equal to 1. Option C, x plus y equal to c. Option D, x by c plus y by c minus a equal to 1. We'll continue the solution. See the solution. Let x comma y be a point on the locus where PA plus PB equal to 2C and PA equal to 2C minus PB. Then by squaring on both sides, two times we have to do the squaring. Finally, we are separating x square term and y square term. Then we'll get the answer x square by c square plus y square by c square minus a square equal to 1. So if you observe here, PA plus PB equal to 2C, PA equal to 2C minus PB, and squaring, again second time squaring, that expansion we are getting x square by c square plus y square by c square minus a square equal to 1. Move to the next question. The locus of the point which moves so that it's the square of its distance from 3 comma 4 is equal to the square of its distance from x axis. Watch the board. See students, it is the locus point P x comma y, it is the given point, and locus point P x comma y, if you consider, the distance from P to x axis is mod y and distance from P to y axis is mod x. So here PA, the distance from x comma y to A, PA is equal to distance from P to x axis given, that is mod y. Then if you do the square, PA square equal to y square. PA square, you know, that is x minus 3 whole square plus y minus 4 whole square equal to y square. If you expand this equation, we will get the answer x square, y square, y square will get cancelled, and x square minus 6x minus 8y plus 9 plus 16, that will become 25 equal to 0. So simple problem only, but in 2D coordinate system we have to learn this one. From a point to x axis distance is modulus of y coordinate, from a point to distance y axis is modulus of x coordinate. Move to the next question. The locus of the point which moves on the line joining the points 2 comma minus 3 and 3 comma 2. Watch the board. Students, here 2 comma minus 3, 3 comma 2, simply two points given. He is asking locus of points lies on the line joining the two points A and B means. So this is not all points locus means, simply it is a line passing through A and B only. You can apply the 2 point form straight line equation, that is y minus y1 equal to y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1 into x minus x1. This is y minus y1 equal to m into x minus x1. So this formula we can apply. Move to the next question. If the line through capital A 4 comma minus 5 is inclined at an angle 45 degrees with the x axis, then the coordinates of two points on opposite sides of A at a distance of 3 root 2 units is. Watch the board. Students, here in straight lines, one more important concept for JEE, that is parametric forms. To find the parametric forms, the formulas are x equal to x1 plus r minus r cos theta, y equal to y1 plus r minus r sin theta. So a line passing through the point x1, comma, y1, and making an angle theta with the positive direction of x-axis, then there is a point P1 and P2, which are at a distance of r units from the given point A. To find these two points, we will apply this formula, x1 plus r minus r cos theta, y1 plus r minus r sin theta, parametric forms of a straight line. So here what is given? This is x1, y1, and r is given 3 root 2. So if you take this one, x1 is 4 plus r minus 3 root 2 into, and theta is given 45 degrees. So cos 45 value 1 by root 2. So this is x coordinate, and y1 minus 5 plus r minus 3 root 2 into 1 by root 2. So root 2 root 2 will get cancelled, 4 plus r minus 3. Then here 4 plus 3 7, 4 minus 3 1. Here minus 5 plus 3 minus 2, and minus 5 minus 3 minus 8. When we are taking plus, we are getting 7 comma minus 2. When we are taking minus, we are getting 1 comma minus 8. That means here important thing is those you can find the formula x1 plus r minus r cos theta, y1 plus r minus r sin theta. Students, in every chapter ending we are giving one question for you, a competitive question, and who is sending SMSs for that one, they are getting gift also with right option. So like this, in straight lines also we are going to give one question. The value of A for which x minus 6y plus A equal to 0, 2x plus 3y plus 4 equal to 0, and x plus 4y plus 1 equal to 0 are concurrent is option A 2, option B 3, option C 4, option D 5. Students, send your answers via SMS in the following format. Type S R D G hyphen M A T hyphen 05. Your option A or B or C or D. Send it to 888-448-6915. First three SMS senders with right option will get a gift. Students, till now we discussed about straight lines. So next episode, I will meet you with a new topic. Thank you.
Vidyadayini Residential School, KR Nagar, Harihar. Admissions open from nursery to 10th CBSE syllabus. Shrimati Radhabai D. Gopal Rao PU College. Admissions open for PUC Science and Commerce. And Vidyadayini Degree College. Admissions open for BCom and BA. Contact today 944-81-15118.